Students, whatever homework is given to you, you have to submit it on the very next day between 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. to the given WhatsApp number, and it is compulsory to submit your homework as your attendance will be marked on the basis of your submission.
Good morning, students. I hope you are doing well at your home, doing your homework regularly, planning your schedule properly. Okay, so today I welcome you all in our today's lecture. Okay, as we have discussed, today we are going to start a new chapter. Okay, in the last lecture we have finished our chapter number 1, that is matter in our surrounding. Okay, today we are going to start the biology section. In that we are going to start the chapter 5, that is fundamental unit of life. Okay, so before starting the lecture, you can see on the whiteboard I have written some of the description related to this chapter. Okay, so if we start this chapter, okay, the heading of the chapter is our first question. You can see here I have written the two question on the whiteboard, that is, what is fundamental unit of life? Actually, this is the title of our chapter, okay, which followed by the next question, that is, what are living organisms made up of? Actually, the answer for both the question is same. Both the question are having the same answer, but they are being asked in different pattern, that is, fundamental unit of life and living organisms are made up of. The answer is very simple, it is cell. Answer is cell. That means our body, every living organism, including plants and animals, myself, yourself, okay, all are made of that fundamental part which is known as cell. And also we can say living organisms are made up of cell. So what is this cell? Okay, how this cell came into existence? What are the history and the discovery related to this cell are being made in the past? All has been written on this whiteboard, you can see. Okay, what is the title? Summary about the cell and its related discovery. Means this word cell, how it came into existence, what are the various type of discoveries and studies are being made related to this word, all is given year wise in this table form. And that is, in which year, which scientist has discovered what about the cell is given in this table. Let's see that one by one. Let's see this first, that is in 1665. In the year 1665, the scientist named Robert Hooke, what he discovered? He discovered that for the first time, you know the bark of the tree, tree ka jo bark hota hai, uski trunk. So from the bark of the tree, it collected some substance, some material known as cork. It's known as cork. And in that cork, what he found? He found the cell for the first time. With the help of the primitive microscope, which is made by him only. Yani 1665 mein Robert Hooke ne kya kiya? Sabse pehle jo tree ka bark hota hai, usme se ek liquid collect kiya. In that liquid, he found out the thing that is known as cell with the help of primitive microscope. What do you mean by that primitive? Yani simple microscope. Jo thoda bahut magnify kara aisa microscope. So with the help of that microscope, he found that the cork, which is the material obtained from the bark of a tree, has some specific characteristic thing inside it. And that thing is nothing but your cell. That was the first time the word cell was discovered by the scientist Robert Hooke in the year 1665. Then the next year, that is 1674, the another scientist named Leeuw van Huyck, what he discovered? He discovered the living cell in the pond water. Pond hota hai talab jaisa. In that pond, what is the water is there, in that water he finds some living cells. Cell in the living form. Okay, that was the second discovery about the cell. Okay, then in the year 1831, another scientist named Robert Brown, what he discovered? He discovered the nucleus in the cell, which is the most important important discovery about the cell. In 1831, Robert Brown discovered the nucleus of the cell, which is the living part of the cell, which is the most important part of the cell, which supervises the cell about its function and organization. So that was the most important discovery about the cell was made by Robert Brown in the year 1831, and that discovery was the nucleus is present in that inside the cell. उन्होंने कहा कि सेल का जो स्ट्रक्चर होता है उसके अंदर एक लिविंग चीज है जिसका नाम है न्यूक्लियस. ओके, देन द ईयर 1839 अनदर साइंटिस्ट नेम परकिन जे, व्हाट ही डिस्कवर्ड, ही कॉइन यानी सबसे पहले उसने वर्ड यूज किया, एंड दैट वर्ड वाज प्रोटोप्लाज्म. दैट वर्ड वाज प्रोटोप्लाज्म. दैट प्रोटोप्लाज्म इज आल्सो नोन एज साइटोप्लाज्म. It's another name for the word protoplasm. Both are same. Either you can say protoplasm or you can say cytoplasm. Both the words are same. But what is this protoplasm or what is this cytoplasm? It's like, suppose ये आपका कोई cell है. Generally cell circular shape के हम assume करते हैं. ठीक है? This is the center part of the cell. ठीक है? Which we call as nucleus. जैसे हम क्या बोलते हैं? Nucleus कैसे तो? This is your nucleus. Right? So whatever the liquid is there, okay? Whatever the liquid part is there, this is the liquid part we have, है ना? So this liquid part is nothing but protoplasm. Okay? So Perkin जी ने क्या कहा कि जो cell है, सेल का जो सेंटर पार्ट है वो न्यूक्लियस है, लेकिन उस न्यूक्लियस के चारों तरफ एक लिविंग मटेरियल है, फ्लूइड है, एंड दैट फ्लूइड दैट लिविंग मटेरियल इज साइटोप्लाज्म और प्रोटोप्लाज्म. ओके, देन इन द ईयर 1838 एंड फॉलोड बाय द ईयर 1839 द साइंटिस्ट नेम स्केल्डन एंड स्क्वान बोथ कलेक्टिवली गिव द सेल थ्योरी. उन्होंने तो पूरी सेल थ्योरी दे दी कि व्हाट इज सेल, व्हाट इट इज मेड ऑफ, व्हाट टाइप ऑफ फंक्शन इट डज, हाउ इट इज हेल्पफुल फॉर आवर बॉडी, व्हाई इट इज स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन यूनिट ऑफ आवर बॉडी. ईच एंड एवरी इंफॉर्मेशन रिलेटेड टू सेल वाज प्रोवाइडेड बाय स्केल्डन एंड स्क्वान इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सेल थ्योरी. देन इन द ईयर 1855 अनदर साइंटिस्ट दैट इज विर्चॉव, व्हाट ही गिव ही सेड दैट सेल्स अराइज फ्रॉम प्री एग्जिस्टिंग सेल. इन्होंने कहा कि सेल है ना, सेल कोई सेल जब मर जाता है, सो जो न्यू सेल वहां प्रेजेंट होते, व्हाट इफ द लिविंग सेल्स आर प्रेजेंट, दैट सेल गिव राइज टू न्यू सेल्स. यानी जो सेल पहले से प्रेजेंट है उनमें से ही नए सेल्स बनते हैं, अलग से कोई फॉर्मेशन नहीं होता. व्हाट इफ द अर्लियर सेल्स आर देयर इन द बॉडी, दैट सेल्स ओनली गिव राइज टू न्यू सेल्स. ओके, दिस वॉज ए स्टेटमेंट गिवन बाय द साइंटिस्ट वर्चॉव. Then in 1940, the important discovery was made, that is electron microscope. Okay, science got success to invent the electron microscope. Okay, and that electron microscope then help us to know about the various minute particles which are there inside the cells, that is cell organelles. Because right now all those scientists have said that whatever the living thing inside us is there, it's a cell. But that cell also has some living material inside it. And what are those materials, how they look like, what are their function, what are the purpose they possess there, all those detailed information was find out with the help of electron microscope. So that is the history of cell and its invention. Okay, these are the various here for their scientist name. Okay, and what they found is written. Okay, so now back to this question, that is what is fundamental unit of life and what are living organism made of. So as I said, both have the same answer, that is cell. All living organisms are made of cell. ठीक है, लेकिन if you talk about our body, ठीक है, हमारी body एक cell है? नहीं, our body is not a cell. Okay, our body is a group of cell, because if we talk about our body, okay, let me tell you how it works. See, if you talk about our body, body is made of organs. Then organs are made of tissues. And tissues are made of group of cells, you can say simply. So we are learning about this thing in this chapter. If you talk about our body has various organs. Hand, leg, heart, kidney, lungs, and a stomach, intestine. There are too much of organs present in our body. All those organs are made of tissues. And tissues are group of cells. When cells form a group, that group is known as tissue. And that tissue is finally made of the simplest form, which is known as cell. Okay? Bada chal gaya? Now the another thing come to our mind. Being a such a complex body, we have too much of organs in our body, and each and every organ perform the various function and different function compared to another. For example, the work which I can do with the help of my hand, is it possible to do with my legs? No. Whatever the function done by heart, is it possible for a lung to do the same function? No. Because heart does the work of pumping the blood. Okay? Whereas lungs do the function of purifying the blood. Both are different. है ना? Heart क्या करता है? Blood को pump करता है, जिससे blood पूरे body में circulate होता है. So heart का काम क्या है? Blood को पूरे body में circulate करना. Whereas lungs की बात करें तो lungs क्या करता है? वो purify करता है blood को. वो circulate नहीं करता. It purify the blood. अगर हम lungs को अब heart की जगह रखते और heart को उठा के lungs की जगह रखते, will our body able to coordinate and do the function as usual? Possible है? नहीं possible. Because whatever the function does by heart as a organ is totally different what is does by the lungs. Why is it so? Because whatever the organ as a heart, it is made of different cells. Whereas lungs is made up of different cells. Both are having different cells altogether. Okay, so that's why they perform these specific functions. So I mean to say that whatever the function performed by different organs in our body, all has a direct relation with the shape, size, and structure of the cells they possess, the type of cells they possess. Okay, हमारे organs के पास जैसे cells होते हैं, उनका जैसा type होता है, वैसे ही function वो करते हैं. And all those functions are totally different from the other organs. They will never match with each other. अब ये interesting बात ये देखने की है कि सारे organs के पास mostly cells जो होते हैं वो common होते हैं. Again there is a twist. Means whatever the cells possessed by the heart and whatever the cells possessed by the lungs, both are having somewhat common cells. But the function they does, the function they perform is totally different from one another. Why is it so? तो उसके लिए हम आगे डिटेल में पढ़ेंगे. Because the reason for that is cell organelle. Because each cell has some special cell organelle inside. Because हमारी body cell से बनी है, लेकिन cell के अंदर भी कुछ है. Cell also has some different peculiar or you can say characteristics thing inside it, which are actually responsible for the various function performed by the cells. Okay, so those different or peculiar things are nothing but the cell organelles. उन्हें क्या कहा जाता है? Cell organelles. That we are going to learn one by one in the different part of this chapter. Okay, now I want to say, now next topic we are going to start, that is okay. Now next, ठीक है, we learn that our body is made up of various organs. Those organs are made up of various tissues, and tissues are made up of various cells. Then we learn that various organs perform various functions which are not common in between with each other. And we also learn that the reason for that specific functions are their cells, their structure, their size, their type. And all those structure, size, and type of different cells are due to their different cell organelles which are there inside it. Okay, now we are going to learn the types of organism based on cells. Yani whatever the number of cells we have in our body, based on that into how many groups the organisms have been divided. That means cells की बात करें, so दो तरह के organisms होते हैं. That is unicellular organism and multicellular organism. Okay, based on number of cells. And जिस तरह का सेल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हमारे बॉडी के अंदर होता है, ठीक है, the type of cell organization our body possesses, based on that our organisms are been classified into these two categories, that is unicellular organism and multicellular organism. What do you mean by those words? It's unicellular means made of one cell only. This is made of more than one cell. Made of more than one cells. This is the simplest difference. यानी वो organism जिनकी पूरी body, the whole body of an organism, when it is made of one cell, it is known as unicellular organism. And when the whole body of the organism is made of more than one cells, how many? उसका कोई calculation नहीं है. More than one cell, in a short. So then those organisms are known as multicellular organism. तो आप बताओ कि इस अभी आपके सामने जो organism खड़ा है, नहीं मैं मेरी बात कर रहा हूँ, मैं unicellular हूँ कि multicellular हूँ? और आप as a body, as a organism, unicellular है कि multicellular है? Think. What is the answer? We are multicellular organism. हम कैसे organism है? Multicellular. क्यों? Because हमारे पास हाथ है, पैर है, कितने सारे body parts हैं, और हर एक body parts को हम organs कहते हैं, और organs tissues से बनते हैं, और tissues cells से बनते हैं. तो देखो ना, एक cell नहीं है हमारे पास, group of cell made tissue. जब tissue में ही group of cell आ गए, so obviously वहाँ एक cell तो होगा नहीं. Group of cell contains more than one cell. अब ऐसा टिश्यू ग्रुप बना के ऑर्गन्स बनाता है, और ऐसा ऑर्गन एज अ ग्रुप पूरी बॉडी बनाता है. सो ऑब्वियसली आवर बॉडी इज नॉट मेड ऑफ वन सेल, सो दैट मींस वी आर मल्टीसेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म. तो यूनिसेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म कौन होते हैं? अगेन बहुत सारे छोटे छोटे जो बैक्टीरिया होते हैं, एग्जाम्पल की बात करें बैक्टीरिया, ठीक है, और एक बैक्टीरिया तो आपके पास फैमिलर हो, अमीबा, ठीक है, अलीबाबा एंड 40 स्टोर नहीं, इट्स अमीबा, ठीक है, उसका नाम है, ठीक है. और इसकी बात करें तो ऐसा एग्जांपल वी कैन टेक प्लांट्स, एनिमल्स एंड ह्यूमन बीइंग, ठीक है. सो दिस आर द एग्जांपल ऑफ यूनिसेलुलर और मल्टीसेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म, ठीक है. अगर ह्यूमन बीइंग की बात करें तो देखो हमारे साथ कितने सारे अलग अलग टाइप के सेल्स हैं. फॉर एग्जांपल ब्लड, आपके बॉडी में जो ब्लड है ना उसके भी अलग से सेल्स होते हैं जिसको ब्लड सेल्स कहते हैं, ठीक है. आपने देखा जब आप अपने आपकी ब्लड रिपोर्ट कराते हो तो उसमें देखना क्या लिखा आता है, आरबीसी काउंट, डब्ल्यूबीसी काउंट, प्लेटलेट्स काउंट, तो वो सब क्या है, दे ऑल आर द सेल्स पजेस्ड बाय योर ब्लड. सो ब्लड के भी सेल्स होते हैं हमारे बॉडी में. फिर हमारा ब्रेन एंड आवर स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, ब्रेन एंड स्पाइनल कॉर्ड की बात करें तो वहां कौन से सेल्स होते हैं, नर्व सेल्स, द लॉन्गेस्ट सेल पजेस्ड बाय ह्यूमन बॉडी. जो नर्व सेल्स होते हैं वो ह्यूमन बॉडी के सबसे लंबे सेल होते हैं. अगर वो सेल नहीं होंगे तो हमारी बॉडी कोऑर्डिनेट ही नहीं कर पाएगी, ठीक है, आप चल नहीं सकते, आप बोल नहीं सकते, आप कुछ खा नहीं सकते, बिकॉज व्हाट इज द कोऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ होल बॉडी इज बीइंग डन, इज डन बाय द ब्रेन एंड स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, एंड बोथ आर मेड ऑफ नर्व सेल्स. दोनों के दोनों किससे बने, नर्व सेल्स से, ठीक है. आपने देखा कुछ लोग हमेशा ऐसे मंद बैठे होते हैं, ना कुछ बोलते हैं ना कुछ करते हैं, है ना, चुपचाप बैठे होते हैं, मत सराउंडिंग में क्या हो रहा है कुछ पता ही नहीं चलता. Why is it so? That means उनका जो नर्व सेल वाला सिस्टम है, उनके जो नर्व सेल्स है वो वीक है. That's why वो जल्दी से चीजों को कोऑर्डिनेट नहीं कर सकते. आपने देखा होगा किसी को जब बॉल फेंक के मारते हैं तो कोई उसे कैच कर लेता है, तो कोई किसी को पता ही नहीं चलता वो ऐसे ऐसे करते रहते, क्या हुआ. सो ये क्यों, बिकॉज ऑफ द कोऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ नर्व सेल्स. आपने देखो कुछ बच्चे बहुत इंटेलेक्चुअल होते हैं और कुछ एवरेज होते हैं. अगेन व्हाई, अगेन इट्स अ नर्व सेल सिस्टम. जिनके नर्व सेल बहुत फास्ट होते हैं, ठीक है, वो बहुत इंटेलेक्चुअल पर्सन होते हैं. और जिनके नर्व सेल्स में कोऑर्डिनेशन थोड़ा स्लो होता है वो एवरेज बच्चे होते हैं। ठीक है, पता चल गया। सो ह्यूमन बीइंग के कुछ सेल्स की मैंने बात की, जैसे स्पर्म सेल्स जो स्पेशली बॉयज में आता है, ओवम सेल्स जो गर्ल्स में आता है, फिर इन दोनों के कॉम्बिनेशन से एक नई ऑर्गेनिज्म का इन्फ्लुएंस बर्थ होता है। ठीक है, ये भी हम सब आगे जो दूसरे चैप्टर्स होंगे उसमें डिटेल में पढ़ेंगे। सो दिस आर फॉर सम एग्जांपल ऑफ द सेल पजेस आवर पजेस बाय आवर बॉडी, ब्लड सेल्स, नर्व सेल्स, स्पर्म, ओवम, मसल सेल्स, बोन सेल्स। ठीक है, मतलब हमारे जो बोन्स है उनके भी सेल्स होते हैं, हमारे जो मसल्स है ये इनके भी सेल्स है, इसकी वजह से इतनी स्मूथ है। देखो बोन की जो सेल्स होते हैं वो हार्ड होते हैं स्ट्रेंथ, इसलिए वो बोन हमें स्ट्रेंथ प्रोवाइड करती है। मसल्स के सेल्स क्या फ्लेक्सिबल होते हैं, सॉफ्ट होते हैं, इसलिए हम इजीली मसल्स को कहीं पे भी मूव कर सकते हैं। ठीक है, तो देखा हमारे बॉडी में अलग अलग टाइप के सेल्स है बेस्ड ऑन दी फंक्शन दे परफॉर्म। ओके ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो इन टुडेस लेक्चर व्हाट वी लर्न इज व्हाट आर दी फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ अ लाइफ, what our living organisms are made of, what are the various terms and history of cell, about its invention, about the scientists who invented it, all those things we have learned in our today's lecture. Okay, and that's all for today. Okay, in the next lecture we will learn about the various cell organelles and their function. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the topic and got the knowledge about it. Okay, take care, bye bye.